guys, so I want to give you one of the best treats we have tonight. The master of disaster, Splendid Eddie.
I'm going to give y'all a hint. He lied. But anyway, I know some people looking at me kind of funny, you know, and I really was scared to wear this jacket. Because I know somebody might say, call the police and say, they got a black dude up there with a NASCAR jacket on. No, he done stole it from a white boy. But anyway, my name is Splendid Daddy, something like a sugar, but not quite. See, what that mean is, see, a sugar daddy can buy his women brand new cars, brand new home, and give them a big bank account. But a Splendid Daddy, the best thing I can do is maybe get $10 or $20 on the light bill. I was raised to be a cusser. You know, I don't know how I'm saying all that stuff clean, but I was raised to be a cusser. My grandfather, you know, he used to cuss, say, get that son of a bitch over there. Go bring me that motherfucker right there. So that's the way that I learned what things were, because he would point and he would say a cuss word. So one Christmas, he bought me a tricycle. And he say, go ride the son of a bitch. Go get on the son of a bitch. And so I went on. He said, that's what I bought it for. Ride the son of a bitch. So, you know, I went on and I got on the tricycle and I rode. But the next day I went outside with the tricycle and little boy next door say, let me ride your tricycle. I said, man, that's not no tricycle. That's a son of a bitch. So, you know, I still ran into problems because, you know, I cuss so much all the time. You know, when you cuss all the time, every day, all day long, and go to church every now and then, you're running some problems. So I went to church and I was there and the preacher, I'm talking about, he was up there and he was cutting up. And he hit a message that struck home real good. So after the service, I say, I got to tell you something, Pastor. He said, what? I said, boy, you preached that motherfucker. You told that song a bitch. Yeah. You know, and he say, look, he say, now, you can't be using that kind of language in the church. I said, well, there's one more thing I want to tell you, Reverend. I said, I put $1,000 in the pot. He said, you bullshit. So, but anyway, you know, I was having trouble in relationships, you know. And I went to the door store, you know, to get me a tart. Now, some of you women, you know, y'all can't really say nothing, you know, because I know y'all got a tart. Y'all got this side piece. A lot of people talking about that side piece, but the side piece being the drawer on the side of the bed, right? And it really don't be fair, because I've seen them, they do two or three things that a man just can't compete with, right? But I got one friend of mine, you know, she say, she want to leave a note on her side piece in the drawer. Deal though, she want to leave a note. And I said, well, what the note going to say? It's going to say, when I die, make sure that you put this in the casket. Because I don't want to take no chances when I get to heaven, because this been giving me heaven on earth. But anyway, at the store, you know, I went in there and I saw the dolls, and I saw one that said it can talk. And I asked the cashier, I said, well, what the doll say? It said, push the button. I saw it, it said, right there, daddy, right there. Right there, daddy, right there. I said, shit, that's the one I want. So I took the doll and I went, you know, and I was working my boogie with the doll. I'm talking about, I'm really working, you know, after. And then the doll said, can you give me a little bit more? I said, that's all I got. He said, well, you need to try to go find some somewhere. I can't find none no what? Well, you need to take me back to the store. Wasting my damn time. My name is Splinter Daddy. My time is up. Thank y'all very much.